Everybody, Super Giant Bigfoot. You know, if there's a part of the forest that kind of creeps me out more than any, it's usually this side of the forest. I say this side mostly just because I'm across the big ravine from where I'm normally out here walking around looking for stuff. When I had Dr. Bindernagel out here a couple of years ago, he found it really remarkable that there was all these broken trees that all sort of fall within a line. One there, there, some up there. And they all pretty much follow a corridor through here. I've walked that area lots of times and never really found any more than just the broken branches. Although there was a what we'll call a major Bigfoot sighting right here. 15, 16 years ago, quite a while ago, right through here. And the creature disappeared, or would have disappeared right about where my bike is. Anyway, I've seen things out here in this chunk of forest, and it goes for miles back this way. It goes a long ways back there. I can hear traffic, I don't know. Probably 2 miles from here. Traffic, sometimes the sound of the traffic just comes screaming in here. I swear the traffic is just behind me, but it's not. You know, I got some people saying, oh, you know, he films up beside a Walmart or whatever that crazy story was. No, what happened here was, I think it's like 2 years ago now, they took a logging road that was a gravel road that some people used to frequent. It was like a shortcut through the forest. Instead of driving all the way around the forest, you could take this perfectly straight road. Make a couple turns, get on this road, and go straight through the forest and get to the other towns that are on, village and town that's on the other side of the forest. Lickety split. So they said, ha-ha, what we'll do is we'll take this and we'll pave it. So they did, they spent all kinds of money on it, they paved it, now it's like a freaking highway. And the roads that used to, you had to stop and turn on, they just made those into smooth curves, so now the traffic just flows right through the forest. If you're going to that town, it's easy going now. So there's up a tree, kind of like this one right here. I saw a very large, furry something. I recorded it a couple years ago. I don't really think I ever did much with the footage. For the life of you, you can't tell what it is. Just a big mass of hair up there. It didn't move or anything. And I ended up giving up trying to make it move, so I left and I came back the next day. Of course, it wasn't there. So I don't really know what it was. It was a massive tree. You know, in order to climb a tree like this, you have to be big and strong to be able to conquer that curvature. Down over here, I found some stone tools a couple years ago. Eventually, I will go back down there and check that area. I don't really like to frequent these areas too much, just because if the creature has some spots where he puts things, I don't want to be constantly going there. Because for all I know, he's probably constantly watching. Let on like I don't know it's there. And one day I'll just casually walk by and check it out. You know, a few times, well actually probably quite a few times, you've heard me talk about seeing this black creature following some people when they were hiking through the forest. I was on one side of the valley, the hikers were on this side of the valley, and this is the trail right here that the people were following. And right there is the tree where it all began from. And I'm standing way back over there somewhere watching this. The creature came up from down there. That's what caught my eye originally, was this black shape moving along here, kind of a, looked like a big dog, because it's on all fours. And it got right up behind this tree, and it kind of sat there. And I was aware of that. That's not a dog, or a bear, or whatever. And then when the people walked by with their dog, and they were completely oblivious to it, this creature, like they were way up there, it got out and scooted along here, walking both with his hands and just on his feet. It was mostly walking with his hands touching the slope. It would stop and go and stop and go, and I lost sight of it after a bit. But yeah, it just came up from behind a big tree and followed them. So I've always got my, I always have that on my mind. I mean, you see these big trees down there and up here. That creature, if he's out here, really could be behind literally any of these trees. I don't mean that to sound paranoid, but, and I know it might sound kind of funny, but it's true. It's how this creature works. It's an opportunistic follower. He's curious, he's going to follow you. There's nothing following me right now, I'm pretty sure, but you never know. Anyway, I got to get me and the bike to the far side of the valley over there. It's going to prove to be fun. Well, here I am at the notorious steps. See, I took the long way around. I haven't gone up and down these steps for a while. And I don't feel like going 6-7 kilometers through the forest just to get just over there. So, it's pretty, looks like pretty impossible right now, but I'll give it a try. It's going to take both hands, so I got to put the camera away. Well, I'm halfway there. Came down the steps, across the creek, and now at the almost non-existent steps on the other side. Okay, here we go. Leave that thing just hanging there. You know, it never fails as I come into this part of the forest. You hear things, usually just as you're approaching. This time it could have been anything. It could have been a deer moving around back there or something. But there was something back there. Something. Don't know what. Again. There's something else there. Sometimes I wish I had a microphone that could pick up all these sounds I hear. Sounds beyond the birds. Isn't that ironic here? I'm seeing that. Anyway. I don't know what that was I just heard. It's a very muffled kind of thud. Be a bad situation for, you know, wild dogs or anything like that to jump out in front of me or behind me. You know, you hear me talk about that a lot. You hear me talk about that a lot in some of these videos about these wild dogs. And that's probably about the only thing I really worry about when I'm in the forest. It's wild dogs. Typically they don't make bangs and thuds though. You know, this is where I normally park the bike. And I parked way down there today. Way down the trail. And you remember, this is where the deer leg was found. It was laying here. And I threw it behind the tree. Well, now on my way back home, the deer leg is laying out here. And it wasn't there before. I rode right through here. And to top it off, there's a pile of leeks here. Right there. And they're new. Look at that. You know, you ever get the feeling you're being watched and you don't know from where? I got that feeling right now. And you know, the mistake I made with the deer leg is that I just picked it up, looked at it, and I was like, ugh, put it back down. But the creature has seen me. If he's out here watching me, he's seen me eat these. So, I'm going to put these in my pocket. Yeah, why not? Sure, put them in my pocket. That's a good idea. Put them here in my sweater. Lovely. I'm going to take these with me. I'm looking back there. I don't see anything. Oops, got some. Yeah, sure. Put them in my pocket. That's a whole lot harder than it sounded. There we go. I'm going to take one and eat it. Shit, I just saw something. Right back. Back through there. I just saw something move to my right in a downward motion. I don't know what the heck I just saw. And to keep the camera on that area, I just got that creepy, shaky, weird feeling just now. Okay. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hold this up like this, and I'm gonna eat it. I'm holding this over my head. I think I see something. Wait a minute. Holy cow, it's hot. Oh heck, I can't see well enough back there on the screen. Right back in there somewhere. Right over there. I'm not sure. Can you eat the leaves on these? I don't know. Oh, it's kind of green. I gotta turn around. Yummy. Actually, it's not bad, it's just a little green. That's not bad. Something. So if I'm being watched, I think I'm being watched from straight ahead there, back behind them two trees. Right back in there somewhere. It was right exactly in the center of the screen where I saw something move across. It didn't look like a creature, like it looked more like an arm through the air and looked down. Looked like to me for a second there. I'm not touching the deer leg. I'm not doing that again. And there's also this tree branch laying here, too, that I don't recall being here. I was just here a while ago. Rode right through here. In fact, I would have ran over this leg laying here. I'm not taking it with me. Watch this. I'm going to... Is there a thud back there? I'm pointing at the deer leg. I'm shaking my head. Walk over here and look at it and shake my head some more. Mm-mm. You know, I really feel silly doing this stuff, but I have a funny feeling that's what gets the results.